Hey, welcome to Box Hunters episode 1. We are looking at Chord Electronics and their new release of the anticipated Mojo 2. We've collected some speculations around the internet, we've done some sketches, and we want to show you what we think will be presented within the next 7 or 8 hours. But first, the backstory of Chord Electronics. So it was founded in 1989 by John Franks, who still is the chief designer of the company. They operate in Kent, in the UK. It's quite a small company with 34 employees, but one of their brightest shining stars, Rob Watts himself, is a consultant. If we take a quick minute to talk about me in relation to Chord, I work in a rather large design studio in the automotive industry. I've done so for the last 7 or 8 years. And the first thing that caught my eye for Chord products was the industrial design. And there is not stated anywhere if it's from agency or if it's from the man himself, but I choose to believe that it's all John Franks. Before my dedication to the design world, I actually similarly as John Franks worked in the air business. John worked for the avionic company and I worked for a company within the space industry. At that workplace there were a filter designer that was and still is a pure genius whom I also consider to be a dear friend. When I listen to my Chord products, I often think of him. He and Rob do great things with chips. The Mojo 2 is announced. If you go to the end of this video, you will see the production photos. But in the meantime, I will show you what I did, what I intended to show you. Since it took a while to compile everything, so I didn't beat the clock. All Chord DACs nowadays use the FPGA and Watt transient aligned filters. And I've read that Chord wants to create equipment that does not add anything to the sound, so it's fully transparent. That a live show should sound like a live show. So we are looking at the current lineup of the Chord products. And we will take a quick look at some of the awards that have been given to Chord. So first out is the most expensive DAC, the Dave, and then we have the tabletop, the TT2. And then we have a Hugo 2. And then we have the cutest. And Mojo. And of course the upscaler, M-scaler. And we're gonna take a look at the main functions. So if you go to the left, you can see all the DACs and the streamers listed. And then you can take a look if you want the portability or just a DAC without headphone amp. Or if you want the preamp, if you want the remote control, which one is the streamer, which one is the upscaler. And then you can see the list of the taps, the magic taps. In this detailed overview, you can see even more information. For example, which of the FPGA chips is used in which DAC. And here we have the overview of the cost in the different countries. And in the graph, you can see that the Dave costs quite a pile of money compared to the little Mojo. Next up is the graph for the taps. So as you know by now, the increased filter length has resulted in improved sound quality. So you should take a close look at these numbers and see which one you can afford, more or less. Otherwise you can take a look at the cake, that's also nice. And next up we're going to take a look at the data going into the DACs. So first up is the PCM stereo with the different FLACs, the 16-bit and the 24-bit with 44.1, the CD quality from the 1980s, the Red Book standard. And then we have DSD, and if you take a closer look at the small text, there's some fun facts, or at least I thought that was fun when I did the research. And you can see maybe that there is some issues with DSD native, unless you have a Windows PC. And then we thought that we could take a closer look at the Bluetooth. The Chord DACs only has aptX, and perhaps they could in the future products use the aptX lossless instead. It's still not even Redbook, but close. And then we have the different indicators for the sample frequency and the battery indicator for the Yuga 2 and the Mojo. And what about streamers? You need a streamer to make the audio sound good into your DAC. Or you could use a laptop or something, but these streamers are quite nice. So if you have a Yuga 2, you can use the To Go. If you have a Mojo, you can use the Poly. If you will buy a Mojo 2, you can still use the Poly, so you could still take a look at that one. And the To Go and the To U can be used with any DAC. Okay, so now we are taking a look at the compiled images I did for the rumors. And it could be a more edgy shape, but now when I see the production photos, it is more or less like this sketch, like the original Mojo with the rounder shapes. And then I thought in this dark image that I saw a little micro USB in the front. That could be a little nice feature, but of course they can't fit that in the PCB. But let's play with the idea that you could have a micro USB there too. If you have it as a tabletop with your stereo equipment and not in your pocket, then maybe some easy access from your phone or something would be nice to access from the front. And then it was a question about this, if it had these four different filters as the Yuga 2, or if it is a mobile button, so if you don't press the mobile button, it's automatically a tabletop functionality. And here in these images I added a USB-C instead of the micro USB. Doesn't really change much. And I think it was not in the production photos, so I guess this was just one of those crazy ideas. So here we have the original Mojo and the Mojo 2 done in Photoshop, that is before these production photos were released. So it was based on these dark images that was released on the Chord website, and I saw that they use the Poly 1 together with the Mojo 2, so there will not be a Poly 2 in the nearest future at least. So what about the names? Do they really love all the different Yugo guys in the world, or do they have a little Bible, or is it just their great British wit that they come up with these amazing names for their products? Yugo! Yugo! Togo! Yugo! To you! Too cute! Cutest! Mobile joy! Mojo! And Mobile Joy 2. The Mojo 2 is here, guys. It has arrived. So here's a quick little guide to the different naming of the current lineup. We have the Dave. meaning the extreme truth, the best one there is. And then we have the scalar, the TT-toot, meaning tabletop. And cutest, here is a little list of the different DACs that was leading up to this one. And then you have the poly, meaning many. So you can connect it with different apps and different, many different ways. So what will this Mojo 2 be called? Will it be the Mojo 2 or will it have a more exotic name? Perhaps it could be something like Mojo TT, Mojo Tabletop, Modo Mobile Desktop, even more pronounced Mobile Desktop, or the Mojo Buddy. Perhaps there is something new cooking over at Chord headquarters in Kent. Perhaps they would make a small M-scaler, a Minimo, a Mosk, a mobile scaler, Scalo. It had a nice meaning, but I forgot that one. And then you have the Joy 2. Joy to enjoy your upscaled audio. And then we have the current lineup. Passing through. Well, it could be something more than just a Mojo, perhaps a new Dave lineup. Perhaps a M-scaler in the David. The Chordet shape. So then I did some speculations or read on the internet a bit, but perhaps none of this is really important anymore since it is official. Some magazines have already been published due to they are digital and not going out by the post. And here you have some pictures from Reddit and HeadFi, and then we have a sunvideo.com that have really nice high resolution images available for us to take a look at. So you can see there is a USB-C together with the two USB micro to be able to fit the poly streamer. And there are even a review published, and the price is official at least one of the UK dealers at £449. So it's finally here, the Mojo 2. Thank you for this. Bye bye.